Welcome to the Mischief. I'm Velen, and this is Little Tiles. Today we're going to be covering little liquids and some colored blocks. A rather short but sweet episode. So you might be noticing that, of course, I am kind of like standing on some flowing water. In fact, it's pushing me around right now. This is part of what we're going to be covering today, as well as a few other things. Let's see if I can actually get out of the water. There we go. All right, so what do we have? We have water. We've got lava. We've got colored water. We've got colored blocks, or blocks that you can color. Basically, this mod is all about design, and it actually has some functionality to it as well. In this case, we're talking about water. As you see here, I can walk into this water, splash, and I'm inside of a bubble, basically, that I made with this. And you can see here I have a water block. Can I walk through it? No, I stand on it. It's a solid. So here's the weird thing. You take a couple water buckets together and you make two water blocks. Same thing with a lava bucket, except you only use one and you can get a lava block. These then you can put in your little bag and create materials. If you just place them in the world before you put them in your bag, they will just end up being blocks like this that are solid. And you can attempt to interact with them, but it's not really going to do much. For instance, I'm right-clicking to pick this up. It doesn't work, and it doesn't hurt me either. I'm not in creative right now. But things like this is actually a tile. So once you select it with, let's say, your chisel, you can choose, in this case, I've got water. You can also choose lava, among other things. And you can then draw with it and create, you know, your area that you can actually transpose through or pass through. And it's water for all intents and purposes. And in this case, it's actually hollow in the center, just like I've got it here, but I actually cut out the floor so that it was easier for me to walk through. But you can interact with it. Let's say that you have some of it that you want to flow in a special direction. For example, let's make a waterfall. Okay, take a bucket. Right-click a tile of any of the liquid, whether it be the lava or the water, and you can change the way that it flows. There we go. We're going to have it go up so that when I come over here and I hold space, I actually go up quite rather quickly in comparison to usual Minecraft. But you also notice that you see that there's a drip here, just one little tiny block. That's all that is. In fact, I will break it away and I will replace it so you can see it's just one pixel of water. Now here's the thing. I'm going to turn around and start drowning. As you can see, I have air bubbles on my hotbar there. Depending upon where it is in relation to you, this liquid is going to function as intended, and you may or may not, depending upon what you have equipped, take damage from basically, you know, drowning. Is the case I was showing you right there. So that works with water regardless of how many pixels there are. You just need one. But with something, and if you notice here, I have this going sideways. I'm not moving. It's pushing me. So I just back up into this, and it pushes me along. One over here, it's kind of like a little slow motion conveyor belt. It's pretty cool. I just put down like one slice of it. Now, with lava, it's going to be a bit different. Yes, you can create it, place it, all that stuff, just like you could with regular water. In fact, you can interact with it as well. You can change it to flow in special directions. You can walk over here, and it's not actually pushing me because it's lava. It acts a little bit differently. This is just one pixel's height. This is 6 pixels height, and it's not interacting with me either. I can change it to move around, doesn't do anything, but it's 7. 7's a magic number. 7 is when it starts to hurt. Yeah. So, yeah, where's the water? Give me the water. Okay, so at 7, lava becomes dangerous. So just keep that in mind if you're using lava for decoration. You don't want it to go any more than 7 pixels thick, or else trouble is going to be had. And, of course, you can, you know, change it. But you notice it's just the tile that I'm interacting with. So I could have this flowing up on this side. I could have it flowing down on that side and across over there. And all the same, it's not really doing much with pushing me. But the water, on the other hand, will. So that's kind of a bit about that, but not a lot. So let's continue on. We've got lava here with, of course, the lava block. And I'm just going to pass through. And I'm in a water bubble inside of a lava bubble. It's just some fun. And I've got like a little opening cut on the other side with green, glowing green. What is going on over here? Let's run through. And of course, you can see here, I painted it. I actually took some of my little paintbrush. I chose just a random green color. And we can make it so that it is... There we go. We can add a couple eyes. There. We can paint the lava. And it still stays animated. It's just really cool how you have a lot of modifications. Speaking of painting liquids, this is painted water. And this is actually not your standard painted water. This is white water. And white water is actually made with a bucket of milk and a water block. So therefore you get white water. What is white water? Well, let me show you. Here is regular water. Here's white water when you draw and place it down. If I were to paint them, this is the difference here. Let's paint both blocks the same color. You notice that, well, it just went bright green over here and this dark green over here. And you see how bright this color is, right? Well, that's the idea. It gives you a blank white palette to start from. That's what the white water is all about. And that's what a lot of the colored blocks are all about. All these white ones in here are basically all the colors been removed. It just has a little bit of some texture on there to represent a block representation, which I will cover in a moment. But you should also know that the water blocks, you notice how we've got like a teal, we've got like this hot pink, we've got a yellow and a bright green. As I go through these, let's look up at the sky. We've got like blue or the teal. We've got like purple. Move over here. We've got like a yellow. And then, of course, we've got the green. So it will actually give you the vision of the appropriate water while you're in it as well. So that's pretty darn slick in my opinion. And of course, you can always interact with those as well just by right-clicking with your bucket and changing them to face whatever direction you want them to as before. And if you look here, we have all these different colored blocks. First, let's go into the inventory. Notice here we've got a ton of colored blocks to choose from. The simple one, colored block clean. We're going to go with this. It's a bunch of blocks of quartz. Gets you 9 colored block clean. And if I continue on down here, color block floor, which you put in a bit of sandstone in the center. Then you've got grainy big, which is cobblestone, and so on. You just keep going with these, and you can change the pattern that these clean white blocks will have that you can use for decoration. And of course, a colored block lighting clean, which is just a clean white block, but it will emanate light automatically. So that's, you know, just one way of getting a very brilliant white or colorable highlighting block. Colored wooden planks, which is actually really cheap. In this case, it's the inverse. It's like bone meal with wood instead of using any kind of quartz. White lava block. You take some milk and a lava block. Then you've got your kind of transparent ones. Colored block clean, which uses some white stained glass and glass. Then you've got your thick, which just uses the white stained glass. Thin, your thinner, thinnest, which you're just taking a white stained glass and turning it into a colored block thinnest. And it will get you a lot of different variety. As you can see here, we've got all these different options. And of course, you've got your transparent ones that you can see through, going from thickest to thinnest in this case. And we've got white lava. Remember, 7 or more pixels thickness and you burn. And then I can still go over here into the white water. So it's just really cool how much you can do with this. In this case, let's take this here and we're going to drag this all the way across over to here. We're going to paint the entire top half of this bright green. So you can see how brilliant of a color you can get with these. And of course, the water and the lava. Water is going to be a little bit transparent. These ones, you get these just like borderless transparent blocks, which are really, really cool. If I were to get a few of these ones, let's put some of these next to each other so that you can see. It actually blocks light, so it's not translucent for light, but it is transparent for visibility. And then you can change the color, and you notice that it actually doesn't stack up. You don't see the walls of the blocks, like you sometimes do at the block borders. You often see like a doubling of the color. It actually has like a connected textures effect, which is really, really nice. So you can make these really big windows and you don't have to worry about like these little tiny like line breaks in the middle of it or something like that. And you can, design to your heart's content. But you can see how effective this is, because if I get just a piece of cobblestone, grab a piece there, and let's put it into my bag, then I want to make this cobblestone, which I should have just had it in my inventory, but it should be fine. In this case, let's go all the way over here. I can make one whole block of cobble, right? And then I can color this with the lime green. You see how that's a really dark texture. It's actually coloring the green over the gray. Whereas if I go over here and we look at the cobblestone texture, which where is the cobblestone texture? I swear I saw it around here. There it is. It's much brighter than a standard cobblestone brick, which I can just place one of those down here. And then we could potentially take a nib out of this and turn it into a little tiles entity so that I can just paint it like so. And you can see the difference because it's such a dark block. That's just the idea behind this. Very simple, very straightforward, really cool. So many options you can do with this. You can build traps. You can build like secret doors. You can have a lot of color options now at your disposal, provided that you're willing to harvest up a lot of quartz. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If so, be sure to give a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Come visit us on Twitch most nights around 10 p.m. We'll see you there. And don't forget, we currently have a contest going on here at the Mischief Speedrun contest that you can still join. We just had somebody complete one. Can you do a better time than they can? We shall see. Hopefully, I will see you guys soon. Take care.